Did she not crush it last night in the concert?
It was an amazing night.
Yeah, it was great.
Amazing.
You guys might have been our greatest concert audience with the dancing going on.
No question, absolutely.
The giant conga line. It was ridiculous. All right, so enjoy your time out here. I follow you, so get it warmed up for
okay.
me. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Beverley Elliott. Give it up.
Thank you, Lee Arenberg. And right back at you, I love you. He's what a great guy. What a great guy to work with. My pal on the show. So, you guys having a good weekend? Is this. We love doing this. We're so lucky that we get to go on the road and be with all of you and meet you all up close and personal. So, sorry to see that it's ending, but
how did you feel when you had to play Granny? Since she's so much older than you in real life, you had to play a character that was so much older than your actual age. Was that weird for you? And having to put on the wig,
Okay, I hate that wig. Let's just get that out there right now. Every morning, hair and makeup. I am in makeup for maybe 5 minutes, maybe 6 minutes. Basically, I come in with my face scrubbed clean. They put on a little white in my eyebrows and maybe some lip balm, and they go, okay, you're good to go. So people say, you must spend hours in makeup. Actually, none. No, that's just me. But the wig, it's all these pins in my head. And the wig master, it was Diane, and then we've had many, many people in the hair department over the years do an amazing job. I want to hand that to them because none of my family are saying, what's with the wig? Because they make the wig look so good, I think. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Because my family would be the first one. You know how your friends go, what's going on? What are you wearing that for? Nobody says that. So I think they do an amazing job with the wig, but it hurts my head. By the 12th hour on set, I'm like, get this thing off. So to answer your question, I love that I get to play someone older. It's freeing, actually, because it's not about how I look, it's not about how skinny I am, it's none of that. It's just about the spirit of this woman. And I thought they were pretty smart casting somebody in their 50s to play someone in their 70s, because if the show went for 20 years, I would still be alive. Right? Yeah. So anyway, thanks for asking. Gold, can I come up with one right now? Come on down to Granny's, we got everything you need. Lasagna, meatloaf, and... Everything's covered in cheese. Nobody pays their bills. But I love them just the same. Come on down to Granny's, cause Granny is my name.
Dreamy, who turns into Grumpy, and then the Leroy. And so there was the same person, but subtle differences. And it was a fun challenge to kind of figure ways to make them different. But no, I don't think Patel and Leroy would get along at all, until the end. And then it would be like happy, and they'd be toasting fake beer, and Granny's eating lasagna and stuff. Guys, I mean, I'm so proud to like call both these guys my friends. Andy West, I first met doing a convention in Chicago. He's just one of the most genuine kind of guys. And when I first met him, I was like, dude, I really like you. And then we come and be castmates in the show. That's been an incredible honor. And for young Henry Mills, I mean, well, we've all seen him blossom and grow into this one of the more interesting young people. He's thoughtful, he's cool, he's smart. He's got a great head on his shoulders, and he's always fun to hang with. And I know you're going to enjoy the next 45 minutes or so with Andy West and Jared Gilmore!
Thank you.
What's up, Double Henry Mill Square? You know what? I just had a great time. I think I got them all warmed up for you.
Well, thank you.
Yeah,
you're
yeah.
On a first name basis with every single one of them.
I try to be. Could you imagine? Let's do a quiz.
Yeah, introduce me to everybody.
Could you imagine? That'll take up all your time. You won't have to answer any questions. All right, well, guys, welcome and enjoy your time. It's so great to see you, bro.
Yeah.
I just want to say to you, it's been an honor to get to know you even better, bro. You're a class act, my friend.
Thanks, man. You really are. As well.
Thank you, my
great
friend.
Experience.
Yeah, really
so.
Cool. And Jared, I'm so proud of you, bro.
Aww.
Who you are, who you're gonna be. I find you like, I get excited when I know you're gonna be at the show, because it's like, just to see who you would become now at 18 years old, I mean, I feel like a crazy uncle, and
no.
You know, I mean, in a lot of ways, I've been cool, like, we've just known you so long, and it's just like, I love that you're not so messed up, and so many kids in Hollywood.
Don't get too excited, because this is what he becomes many years later.
I know. So. He could only wish he could have a beard like that.
I'm still working towards yours.
Oh, dude, cause that's because I got nothing on top.
I'm gonna get there one of these days.
You won't lose your hair. You'll be fine. You look good. It's always good at the mom's father and see how his hairline looks. That doesn't mind it. But anyway, you guys, I love the Henry Mills. I'm a Henry Mills fan, and enjoy Henry Mills Square! Give it up!
Hey. Thanks, guys.
What was your responses to the show, and then what is your favorite characters? Not counting yourself.
Can I say original recipe Henry? Is that in my lap? I mean, it's not me.
Now I feel obligated to say, older Henry.
See, I set you up for that.
Yeah, you set me up. Yeah, so, it's funny, when I watch the series, it's kind of like a home video of me growing up. So it's a bit weird. And it's funny, I can watch the earlier seasons because I'm just totally different. And it's not even like I'm the same person, but when I go and I see the end of season six and the beginning, season seven, I'm like, it's hard to watch myself. It's not my thing. But I love the writing, I love all the plot twists. The normal movements of an awkward teenager, so
I still have those moments. I've not been a teenager for a long time.
Thank you. It's brilliant.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Savannah. First of all, I love you guys so much. My question is, who is your celebrity crushes growing up?
Are you looking at me? Okay, totally. I don't really get celebrity crushes. I just crush on anime characters. I could start the list, but that would take up the rest of the panel, so I'll just say one for the time being. Toka from Tokyo Ghoul. No, some people may get that, some people may not. It's all good. Andy?
Yeah, I don't, you know, I never had like a serious, like, you know, I was never one of those people that had like a
a poster of somebody. That just wasn't me, really. So I didn't have like a strong thing that defined an era of my childhood. But my version of Jared's anime was probably WWF growing up. I know we're going far away from a celebrity crush, but I was like obsessed with pro wrestling. So like that like defined a large era of my childhood, doing like double axe handles off of my couch to my friends when I was like eight, no celebrity crushes for me, just lots of fake fighting.
Because he's technically older than me, I'll just use another one of mine. Like Mercy from Overwatch.
I don't know who that is, but
he'll teach. We'll talk about it.
We'll talk about it.
He'll educate me afterward.